Hello, what's your name?
Jack Rhodes.
And is what you're going to do today how you make a living, or do you have a normal job?
I did have a normal job.
Which was?
Which was a nuclear engineer.
Flipping it!
Which makes me sound cleverer than I am, to be fair.
And how did your parents feel when you gave up being a nuclear scientist for being a magician?
They weren't impressed, yeah. My dad used to call me a part-time wizard. Sorry, full-time moron. He's not my biggest fan.
Aww. Do you think you could win?
I think at the end of this, you'll either be going, wow, how did he do that? Or you'll be going, wow, why did he do that?
At least he's honest, though.
So you could see yourself in Vegas?
Yeah, that'd be the dream. I think the go-to guys would be Penn and Teller doing a show like that. Yeah.
Not going to ask any more questions. Good luck.
I'm pretty surprised you don't recognise me. I might have been on before.
Go on.
When?
You didn't see me. Do you remember the invisible magician, the Phantom?
Yes.
Yes!
That might have been me.
No!
You can't see me.
Oh!
You'll never see me.
Oh, my God.
I'm standing right in front of one of the judges.
You didn't see me at the time, because I'm like a gangly ninja. I can move undetected. I'll show you what I mean, using these blank cards. Now, Simon, I'm going to have you write down a word for me. What's the first word that comes to mind when you look at me?
Remember, it's a family show.
Yeah. What have we got? Cucumber.
I don't know why.
It's the tall, skinny cucumber and... Simon, hold out your left hand for me. Put your right hand on top. We're going to sandwich it. Perfect. Cucumber in between. Make sure I don't get to it, OK? Now, I get to get my own back now.
Oh, no.
When I look at you, the first word that comes to mind is... minted.
Minted.
Bruno, hold out your left hand for me. Perfect. Minted. Yeah. You're going to put your right hand on top, sandwich it. Make sure no one can get to it. Perfect. Two different words. Cucumber. Minted. I'm now going to move undetected. That's it. Job done. Simon, show everyone what's now written on your card.
No.
Minted. And if you've got my word, Simon, Bruno, show them. Cucumber.
I can't believe this is not real.
What the hell?
Now, here's the thing, OK? I'm going to show you exactly what just happened. Now, Simon, cucumber. Put your right hand on top, sandwich it. Make sure no one can get to it. Bruno, exact same thing. Minted. Right hand on top, sandwich it. Now, here's what you didn't see the first time, OK? I'm going to do action replay, but this time in slow motion to show you how I move undetected, all right? It's like an out-of-body experience. Here we go.
What the hell is going on?
Job done. Undetected. All right, I'm lying. Really, I'm lying. Show him.
What?
No.
I've been lying the whole time. At the start of this, I showed you a video claiming the Phantom was me allegedly. But I posted another video, a prediction, called What Simon Will Think Of. Uploaded 6 months ago, you were only ever going to think of one word. Cucumber.
That's unbelievable.
Wow.
No way.
How? Ladies and gentlemen, I've been Jack Rhodes. Thank you very much.
What's that about then?
Cheers, mate. Thank you. Thank you. Alesha, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Cheers. Cheers. Bruno, it's been so good being here. Thank you. Cheers. Thanks for having me. Cheers. Alesha, it's been amazing. Thank you. Cheers. Simon, it's been an absolute pleasure. Thanks for having me, man. It's been amazing. Cheers, guys. Thank you.
I am so confused. Is that the end of the act?
Is that the end?
I think so. Is that it? Are you done?
Yeah, we're doing the judging bit now, or...?
We're just slightly distracted by the box and the scuba diver.
Scuba diver?
The phantom. I loved the way you presented that. I've never seen it done like that before. That felt really fresh. You're very cool with a sick sense of humour as well, which
like
I love.
Like a cucumber.
See?
I cannot get out of my mind because I held this card. How you do it. I'm gobsmacked, that's all I can say.
You've got great showmanship, it was funny, you've kept us on our toes, and I can't wait to see what you might get up to next.
I think you're really smart, and I think to be a great magician, you've got to be really smart. You have massive potential, I genuinely mean that.
Something really good about you.
Cheers, thank you.
The only thing lacking for me was the ending didn't feel big enough.
To it because the end was big.
Let's take a vote. Bruno.
Yes, yes.
Alesha.
I'm saying yes.
Don't think we've ever seen anything like that. 100% yes. Simon.
That's as good as you're going to get. You got four yeses. You made me feel.
Dad's got it wrong, I think.
Oh, yes.
Cheers. Wicked! Come on, Dad, bring it in. That was amazing.
Good performer.
That was hilarious.
That was so
good. I'm
going
to show you how I did it.
Hype me up. How everyone doing? All right, cool. Let's go.
I think you can.
Today, I'm going to be creating a magical moment in time. I cannot do that alone. I'm going to need the help of the four lovely judges. Bruno.
Yeah?
Can I borrow your watch, please?
Okay, here we go.
Show everyone, hold it up, bye. Can you not all see the watch?
Oh, that's a nice piece, isn't it?
He's doing well for himself, isn't he? Yeah?
What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put your watch in my handkerchief. Can you feel it? Just make sure it's still there.
Yeah, it's still there.
Rule number one, never trust a magician. Poof. In this bag, I've got 50 photos of Simon Cowell's memories. To show you they're all different, I need you to select a random photo. Bruno,
right,
can you close your eyes and take a random photo? Yep, take one, just one, reveal it and show Simon.
I remember that. That is the premiere of the One Direction movie. I've got a great tan.
Okay.
Oh, look at that.
It's you and King Charles.
Looks like I'm being told off.
Now, Simon, we're going to do this slightly different.
OK.
With your right hand,
yeah,
I need you to pick a random photo. Close your eyes.
I really am trying.
And pick a random one, anyone you want.
Anyone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
OK, do not open it. Same thing with your left hand. You can open your eyes.
Yeah.
Hang on to that and follow me.
I'm kind of scared. What's going to happen?
What about my watch?
Now, Simon, about a month ago,
yeah,
I had a dream about two memories. In fact, it wasn't my memories. These was, in fact, your memories.
Really?
The first dream that I had was a memory about unconditional love. There was a lot of barking by dogs, and it woke me up. Do me a favor, Simon. The first photo with your right hand, can you please reveal that photo, please? Show the camera, please.
It's Pebbles.
It's the new one.
After my dream, I had this made. It's a custom dog tag with the name Pebbles.
No, you didn't.
Have a look.
Are you serious?
What?
It's unbelievable.
So now, the second dream I had, you made a purchase for £10,500 on the 21st of March, 1994. I want to show you something, Simon. Do you recognize this?
Yeah. That's a TR6.
Oh my gosh.
Have a look at your photo.
What?
What?
That's my car.
I remember that car.
That was one of my favorite ever cars.
Now, Simon, I am about to reunite you with someone special. Simon Cowell, let me reunite you with the blast from a past. Simon, this is your exact car from
really?
30 years ago, exactly the same one, if not a duplicate. Come round here, Simon, come round. Simon, do me a favor.
Yeah?
Go inside the glove box. There's a gift inside there, Simon. Do not open it,
okay,
but take it out.
All right.
Let's go back and stay. Give it up for Simon one more time.
This is like unreal.
Smashed it.
Simon.
Yeah.
Give that box to Bruno, but do not open it.
Bruno.
One more time for Simon Cowell and the judges. Bruno, open that box.
Oh my God. How did you do?
If Bruno watch, guys.
That's unbelievable.
Thank you, guys. Glad you enjoyed. Magician Trixy, guys.
I was very engaged in the storytelling, you know. I was totally taken by your magic.
Thank you.
What I think I loved most about it all was that it was proper magic, but it was big magic.
That time of my life, I was literally broke. I borrowed some money and I bought that car. And it was like a turning point in my life. Just seeing how much, obviously, this means to you, I had no idea what was going to happen next.
Were you really nervous? nervous at the beginning? Because I felt it.
Slightly.
You've got to start believing in yourself more because you're so talented. If this is an indication of what you can do going forward, I really believe great things are going to happen.
OK, we're going to take a vote. Bruno.
Oh, definitely yes.
Thank you.
Nicely done. It's a yes from me. Thanks. It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
4 million yeses.
Hello!
Hey!
OK, what's your name?
We're Jay and Joss. We perform magic.
Oh, well, there you go.
We like a bit of magic.
What's the reason to come and audition for Britain's Got Talent?
We'd love to take a show to Vegas.
That's the dream.
And for us to do that, we'd need money to make it happen, right?
Well, this could make it happen, so yeah. Let's see it.
Thank you very much.
The ambition of Vegas, this has got to be good.
One of the first questions we always get asked is how did we meet? Well, it was actually at the world's largest magic convention where we developed feelings for each other and became a couple.
That is really cute.
And then in 2019, I surprised Jay with this. I found the love. And 4 years later, we got married. But the one thing that we haven't got around to doing yet is organising our honeymoon. So, judges, we need your help. Now, first of all, we need to know when we are going. So, Simon, I have this balloon.
Sure.
Now, we need a date, a month, and a year. Simon, can you pick the date for us?
I'm going to say the 7th.
Thank you very much indeed. If you could pass the balloon to Amanda. Amanda, you're going to be choosing the month of the honeymoon.
August.
August. Good choice.
7th of August. Expensive school holidays. Just stitch them right up there.
Alesha, what year is it going to be?
Well, what about 2025?
That sounds like a good idea. Bruno, please make your way all the way around to the front of the table. Just there's perfect. Judges, you've been holding onto this balloon for the entire time. Bruno, if you shake that balloon, you'll notice that there's something inside.
Yeah, there is.
Keep very still. It's a note. Read it out loud.
Oh, I can't believe this. 7/8/2025.
Oh, wow.
No! It's impossible.
Wow.
Really?
That's good.
How did they do that?
Alesha, how much money do you think we're going to spend while we're there? Be aware, Simon's paying.
Keep it low, keep it low.
7,750p. 50p.
Thanks, Alesha.
Now, Amanda, you're going to be choosing our hotel room number.
127.
And Simon?
Yes?
What celebrity friend of yours is going to entertain us while we're there?
OK, Nicole Scherzinger.
That's a good book.
That's a good one.
That is perfect, but we still don't know where it is we're going. So, I have honeymoon destinations from all over the world. Paris, we've got Hawaii, Bali, just to name a few. Simon, you're going to be choosing where we go on honeymoon.
OK.
Pull down on one of the strings.
Anyone.
Anyone. Give it a pull.
It's got to be... It's going to be...
Give it a pull. And tell everyone, what have we got?
Oh, Christ. Blackpool.
Blackpool?
There's nothing wrong with Blackpool. Blackpool's fun.
We are going to Blackpool. All completely random choices that we couldn't have known before we arrived here today. What if we were to tell you that we could move forwards in time in just the blink of an eye? To an exact date.
You can't.
In an exact location.
You can't.
Impossible, right?
Yeah.
You see, just in those few seconds, we managed to move forwards in time to our dream honeymoon. So while we were there, we actually managed to film this video.
No, behave.
We're on a honeymoon.
We'll never forget this day.
Cheers.
What's this?
No!
So, the money Alesha's going to give us?
Well, we already know that Alesha's going to give us exactly...
Perfect. Here to the hotel?
Yeah, what was the room number again? I really hope the weather picks up a little bit.
You would have thought that Simon would have picked somewhere
a bit more exotic. Oh. Where are we?
Blackpool?
Brilliant! Oh, brilliant!
Really? But what celebrity friend is Simon sending?
Jay, look!
They got shows here!
What's going on?
That's impossible.
Is it him?
I don't know how you did it.
Sorry, I need a minute. Oh, you cheeky little... Honestly? Wow, you are so likeable. The magic was incredible, how beautifully you worked together. This is a really strong audition. Yes. I loved it.
Oh, thank you so much.
Great storytelling. I love the fact that you're together because there's that connection, which is gorgeous. It was absolutely brilliant.
It's so original, it's so unexpected, and you do feel the magic happening in front of you. So, Simon,
I've always said that I do believe in magic, and that was proof that I've been right all these years. I swear none of it was planned in advance.
Yeah.
It's just blown my mind.
Voting Alesha.
I'm saying yes.
It's a yes from me.
And yes for me.
Obviously, yes.
Thank you very much.
Good.
That was great.
That was incredible.
Well, how did they do it?
Oh my gosh.
What's going on?
Ooh. What's happened?
This is terrifying.
We've been here before.
Oh my God, that sounds scary. One of them took me into the basement.
They've been on the show before.
Have they?
Yeah, all three of them individually.
We have come from a time where there is no magic.
A time when childlike wonder and the feeling of magic has been destroyed through technology.
And without magic, the world's crumbling. It's turned to nothing. It's just turned to fog. And as hard as it might be to believe that we've somehow travelled in time, we can provide you with some kind of proof. If I were to ask you to choose, for example, one of these cards, I can tell you that I know that you will choose the Four of Clubs. And I know that you'll choose the Two of Hearts. And I know that because we've been here before and we've already seen this happen. So would you touch any card you'd like? Just touch one? Yes. Take it out? Good. And Alesha, would you touch one as well? Just take one out. And I know, even though all the cards are totally different, I've seen it happen already. I know that you have, Bruno, the Four of Clubs. Have a look.
What?
and I know that you have the two of hearts.
Wow. I'm impressed. I am impressed.
Amanda.
Yes?
Can you dry out the teacup for me and place it back down? Perfect. You just do the saucer as well for me. Perfect. We're going to place the saucer on top of the cup. Hold your hands out now. I want you to take hold of this. Hold it up really high. Now, for us to travel through time, to travel through a portal, we actually turn to dust. But when we manipulate time, we damage the very fabric of reality. Everything is slipping through our fingers, and the world is turning to fog. Things aren't where they're supposed to be. Look inside the cup.
Oh my gosh. That sand is in the cup.
Oh my God.
Well, sometime in the future, we found a journal.
As we started to study the journal, we noticed that every page contains a different theory about time travel.
Bruno, hold your finger out like this. I'm going to riffle down the pages, and I want you just to put your finger in one of these pages. Right now, this one. Okay. Page 73. This is how to travel into someone's memory.
This page describes to us how that feeling that you sometimes get in the back of your head, that you might have seen something before, it's more than just a feeling. It's actually there to provide you with proof that you really are reliving something.
While he does that, Alesha, Amanda, I would love you both to examine these dice. Just roll them gently a few times on the desk. Just make sure they're regular, real dice that they roll on different numbers. Would you kindly roll that into the bowl? And let's see, you have rolled the number 4. Amanda, would you do the same thing, please? Would you please roll into the bowl as well? 6. Perfect. 4 and 6.
Oh my God, look.
As we start to play with and collapse time and space, sometimes hard to tell if we are on the outside of the hourglass and looking in. Or if maybe we might really be on the inside and we're looking out.
From the past to the present and the present to the future, magic can only be protected by those who possess the ability for childlike wonder.
And those who can take that feeling and carry it into the future.
Good to see you, Ben. Bang on time. Colin, Elizabeth. Feels like 2024. Simon, can I just say, you are looking amazing. You are Bruno. Good to see you, Bruno. My name's Aiden. Sometimes the things that feel like they're happening spontaneously in the present have actually been written into our lives far in the past. The numbers you all chose earlier couldn't have been more random, yeah? But long, long before tonight's show, Ben had seen them, and he knew these numbers would be the only thing that proves time travel is real. So he wrote them down in a place where they could never get lost and never be altered.
Random numbers chosen in this very moment. 4 and a 2 from a deck of cards. A random book opened to page 73. And of course, 2 dice rolled to the numbers 4 and 6. Numbers hidden by the passage of time, and now proof that that feeling at the back of Ben's head is more than just a feeling.
Don't worry, you got this, Aiden.
What?
No! 4!
There's one more thing that we need to share with you.
Nothing is as it seems.
Simon, it's time. For what?
Shave his head off.
Why does it always end up being Simon?
Would you stand up and come with me? You're completely safe, I promise, okay?
Oh no.
Thank you, sir. I'm gonna put a blindfold on you, but you are safe, okay?
Oh my God.
Nothing is as it seems.
What is Simon?
God in the in-between.
Where is Simon?
I'm scared.
Nothing is as it seems.
Hello? Hello? Where am I?
Teacher, Mr. Neeland, set me a challenge. I brought these things from my classroom, this book and these inspiration cards. As you can see, they're all different pictures. I want to make some magic with them. Bruno, take these.
Yes.
Alesha.
Hello.
You take this.
Thank you.
And Amanda, you take these. Now. My favourite book, Bruno.
Yes.
Take your cards, put them into the book.
Okay. One, two, and three.
Alesha, please do the same. And finally, Amanda.
Okay.
Now, Simon, you're going to help me create a moment of real magic. Take one out.
Okay.
Now another.
Okay.
Another. Another.
Gosh.
And finally, one more.
That one.
That leaves us with only one bookmark.
Yep. Okay.
And you can put those cards on the map.
Okay.
Turn the page to where that bookmark has been placed. Now look at the very last word on the right-hand page. Don't say it out loud and show Amanda.
Okay.
Using the power of real magic, let's make what you're thinking of a reality.
Okay.
You won't believe it, and strange as it sounds, extraordinary magic follows you around. I see it, I swear I do, I see extraordinary magic in you.
Simon, what word are you thinking of?
It really was this feather.
No way.
You know, Simon, sometimes magic can be right in front of your eyes. You just need to know where to look.
So I'll keep my eyes open, awed and amazed, and if you start to doubt it, I'll remind
Feather.
You of
F-E-A-T-H-E-R.
God, magic.
Brilliant.
Wow.
Wow, you were giving me Matilda vibes. You have got a bright future. That was
Thank
wonderful.
You.
Well done, Ella.
Ella, no, I really enjoyed it. I had no idea how you did it.
People laugh at me when I say this, but I actually do believe in magic. People do have special powers, and I loved your whole presentation.
Thank you.
You had us absolutely spellbound.
Thank you.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me.
When you got it, you got it. You got four yeses.
Thank you.
Well done, Ella.